The chairman of the National Committee on Indigenous Peoples, Alan Kapuyan, draws flak for accusing a lawmaker of lying during a House Appropriations hearing. Bayan Muna Representative Ephemia Kulamat had asked if there was a conflict of interest with the NCIP chair, also being a member of the country's anti-insurgency task force. But Kapuyan maintains that the work he does for the national task force to end local communist armed conflict is pro bono. He also denies that the NCIP has become a secretariat of the task force.
Marami ka pong sinasabi, Congressman Kulyamat, na mga kasinungalingan. Nabubuhay ka sa propaganda at sa turo sa iyo ng presinta.
Do not accuse a member of this house of telling lies in this budget hearing. You are here to present your budget.
Meanwhile, at that same hearing, some officials from the Social Welfare Department were also grilled over why some social amelioration beneficiaries have still not yet received their cash aid. Gabriela Partilist Representative Arlene Brosa says these beneficiaries have been tagged as paid despite having received no funds. The DSWD says they will look further into this issue. Now, Malacanang is defending the government's multi-billion peso deal with Farmily, even after Senator Risa Ontiveros revealed that the company's executives have pending arrest warrants overseas. Ontiveros had uncovered that the chairman of Farmily International Holdings is wanted for securities fraud, embezzlement, and stock manipulation. Other key officials in the firm were also flagged abroad for their links with other questionable firms. The palace, however, maintains that it got a good deal from that pharmaceutical firm, Farmily.
Why is this government transacting with fugitives? Bakit tayo nakikipagnegosyo sa mga taong may warrant of arrest? Warrant of arrest pa nga sa ibang bansa.
Ultimately, it's the price and the specification that matters. Sa presyo po ang labanan, kahit sino ka man. Eh, unfortunately, wala pong ibang kumpanya na makakabigay ng 1-7. Wala pong kinalaman ang mga personalidad.
Duterte's spokesman then hit back at the previous administration, claiming that the Aquino government purchased PPEs at a higher price even before the COVID-19 pandemic.
Pakita po namin. Dokumento po ito. 1,700, sabi nila, overpriced. Eh, ang binili ng administrasyon ni Presidente Aquino, 3,500. Kailan? September 28, 2015. Matter of days bago bumaba sa pwesto ang Aquino administration. Magkano binili na ng PPE? 3,800. June 23, 2016. Ilang araw bago bumaba sa pwesto, Senator Drilon, please explain. Bakit ang mga kakampi mo doble ang halaga ng binili para sa mga PPEs sa panahon na wala pa pong pandemya?
But former Health Secretary Janet Garin says that these PPEs they procured were used to deal with the threats of Ebola and MERS, COV. Garin insists that proper public bidding was done for these supplies. Philippine Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon is accusing presidential spokesperson Harry Roque of acting like a troll for bringing up the Aquino administration's previous purchases of personal protective equipment. Drilon points out that the Audit Commission did not question that transaction. He also slammed Roque for defending Farmily Pharmaceuticals multi-billion peso contracts with the government when its starting paid-up capital was less than 625,000 pesos.
Secretary Roque says, hindi baling mababa basta naka-deliver. Secretary Roque, I would invite you to read your law because among the standards required is the legal capacity, the financial capacity of a company entering into a contract with the government. There is a whiff of corruption that we should be man enough to admit merits an investigation.
Meanwhile, Drilon says that the Philippine government would have saved 284 million pesos last year had it not gone through a middleman. Senator Bongo is refuting claims of unethical behavior, saying that he's willing to face any investigation. Senator Richard Gordon said that at least four senators are in favor of looking into Go's links with former officials who were tagged in the questionable purchases of COVID-19 supplies. Go is daring his accusers to show proof of his supposed unethical behavior, as he insists his conscience is clean. President Duterte's longtime ally, in a privileged speech on August 31st, said that he's willing to resign if the allegations of corruption against him are proven. Senator Bongo is refuting claims of unethical behavior, saying that he's willing to face any investigation. Senator Richard Gordon said that at least four senators are in favor of looking into Go's links with former officials who were tagged in the questionable purchases of COVID-19 supplies. Go is daring his accusers to show proof of his supposed unethical behavior, as he insists his conscience is clean. President Duterte's longtime ally, in a privileged speech on August 31st, said that he's willing to resign if the allegations of corruption against him are proven.